Today in the news, we've got 6 shades of Nvidia, an apology from Bethesda, and some microtransactions. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Alright, so the 1060 was already pretty infamous for its number of different versions. We have 4 versions that are available in most markets: the 3, the 6GB, the GDDR5X model, and the one with 9 gigabits per second memory. There are other models too, which are available overseas. The thing is, this happened mostly incrementally. As time went on, some upgrades were made, like the memory speeds and type changes, and even the chip itself changed in March of 2018. This time, things could be different right off the bat. It looks like Nvidia might go as far as to ship the RTX 2060 in 6 different variations. According to video cards, Gigabyte filed 40 different cards with the EEC. Out of these 40, 6 models were recurring. If we look at the Aorus line, you can see a pair of 6GB models, 4GB models, and 3GB models. Each pair is differentiated by the last character in the name. It's either a GD, which so far means GDDR6 memory, or GC, which is guessed to be GDDR5 or 5X memory. Here's my take on this. I'm not raising my pitchfork just yet. Right now, it's just a leak, but it all depends on how Nvidia will actually present and announce those models. Will they just shut their mouths and say, we have a new RTX 2060, and just sneak all of the different models in, or will they actually make it clear? I mean, they have been pretty sneaky in the past with this stuff, especially when there's a huge gap in performance like with the GT 1030 DDR4 and DDR5 debacle. What are your thoughts on this? If explained clearly, would you let Nvidia off the hook for this? I mean, they could technically just change the naming scheme for like RTX 2060, 61, 62, 63, but that would also be pretty confusing. Moving on, in gaming, it looks like Bethesda is feeling generous or apologetic. After the continuous fails that Fallout 76 brought to the gamers, Bethesda wants to give those who played in 2018 a little bit of a gift. If you own Fallout 76 on PC, PS4, or Xbox, you can redeem a copy of their Classic Collection, which includes Fallout, Fallout Tactics, and Fallout 2. I'm honestly a little bummed that they didn't include anything slightly more recent like Fallout 3 or New Vegas as a proper apology. Anyways, this is far from enough as the game is still properly broken and new glitches and bugs keep getting discovered every day. One thing that is pretty interesting though is the people who use mods or cheats are actually getting banned. Good, but to get unbanned, they need to send an essay on why the use of third-party cheat software is detrimental to an online game community. Well, how about you, Bethesda, write an essay on how the use of a 21-year-old engine is not the best idea when you want to try a brand new online open-world concept. For those of you who don't know, the creation engine used in Fallout 76 is based on the Gamebryo engine, which is itself the 1997 NetImmerse engine that was used for Morrowind. Sure, they made many upgrades and kept repairing it, but at this point, it's like continuously having to repair a car. You're gonna need to fix it more and more often, so just build, buy, or borrow a new one. Also in gaming, it looks like dear old Battlefield 5 is almost ready to jump into the microtransaction game. As you might know, microtransactions have been held back from launch because they wanted us to get familiar with the company coin system first. Well, an Amazon listing for B-coins has popped up on Amazon, and it looks like the system will launch on January 18th. You'll be able to get 6,000 Bitcoins, B-coins for $50. I know that the B-coin will only be available for cosmetic items. It's unclear if some cosmetics might be locked to B-coins though. I do think that Battlefield is taking the right steps to implement their microtransaction system. What do you guys think? Let me know down below. And that is pretty much it for the news, guys. Don't forget to stay tuned for the live stream. Hopefully you've enjoyed the video. I'll see you guys in the comment section to discuss today's topics. Have yourselves a great day, and I'll see you guys on the next one.